Today we're going to be talking about newborn testing, and you guys should have previously learned about heredity and genes and where you come from. We're going to talk about a little bit about babies today. For the do now, if everybody will read over these three things right here on the screen, and come up to the whiteboard and write down the first word that pops into your head when you read these things. And I've already said babies, you can't write that down. So if everybody will come up to the whiteboard and just kind of write down the first word that pops into your head.
Even if it's completely irrelevant?
Yeah.
One word for each one or just one word?
Just one word.
So we're writing down one word for each of those?
No, just the whole thing. Let's see. What you guys come up with. So I'm assuming that you guys don't really know anything about these things.
I
don't know why you would think
that.
Monkey?
Yeah, like testing, because to test baby or like the psychology behind babies, they test monkeys a lot of the time.
Oh.
Hello.
Yeah, I was trying to get a hair off my shirt.
I know I didn't do the word one word.
Testing, high intensity care, behavior, monkey system, and scale. Behavior was one that popped in my head. I did this before I researched all of these. And behavior and, of course, like ICU, like in a hospital, kind of popped in my head. So now we're going to just go over our learning targets and get into what all of these things actually are. So if somebody wants to volunteer to read the standard for me, please.
Investigate what medical testing that the newborn might undergo over the course of the first few days of life. Newborn testing examples include but not limited to A, APGAR score, B, Braselton Neonatal Behavioral Assessment Scale, and C, Neonatal Intensive Care Unit Network Neural Behavioral Scale.
Okay, thank you. And then if somebody will volunteer to read two learning targets and then somebody else read the last two learning targets.
I can explain three newborn tests, APGAR score, Braselton National Behavioral Assessment Scale, and the NNS. I can analyze the pros and cons of each newborn test.
I can identify which type of newborn test would benefit a newborn baby the most, and I can explain what each test does to help the newborn by creating a brochure for expectant parents.
Okay, thank you. And then for our behavioral expectations today, we're going to be respectful, communicate with your group, be involved, stay on task, ask questions, and have fun. So we're going to be, right now you're kind of in your home groups. Let's see. So I'm going to have, there's going to be three expert groups, and I think, Carly and Ashley, you're going to be the first expert group. Travis and John, you'll be the second expert group. So group one, group two, and then Keith and Madison, if you'll be group three. And I'll show you what you guys will be doing in your groups. But you guys will be you'll have about 5 to 7 minutes in your expert groups to gather information about your different tests that you'll be assigned. And then when I tell you to move back to your home groups, go back and talk with your group about what you learned and take notes, because there will be an assessment on these about overview newborn testing later in the class. So actually, we're going to do, you're in group one, group two, group three, group one, group two, group three. And then you guys are in your home groups now. So if you are group one, if you'll meet over by that whiteboard, And if you're group two, if you'll meet over here where Travis is sitting. And then group three, if you'll meet on this table over here.
Wait, you're two?
I'm two.
I'm definitely three. We're three.
Yeah.
Just right here.
Over here.
Okay. Okay, so this is where your electronic device comes into play. If you're group one, you're going to use this QR code, and then for the others, you have group two, group three. It comes up with an article. I think one is shorter than the others. For the longer ones, if you just read the headings, it'll help you out a lot to find what kind of information you're wanting to get on all of your articles. So if you'll go ahead and come up here and scan, you might be able to do it from your seat. I'm not sure.
Hold your camera up and that thing that popped down.
Two pros and two cons to the type of testing that you are assigned to. And then you're going to have to give some background information and just tell what it is to your home groups and how it's used to assess newborns after the birthing process. And I'll come around and see if you guys have any questions. You guys do have an academic language handout in front of you, and you guys can take notes on that. Back of that sheet. Did not fill out that assessment until after we go back to our home groups and teach. I said those who have the longer articles, if you guys just scroll down and look at the headings, it'll kind of direct you to the type of information that you're looking for. three more minutes. About a minute and a half. Seconds. You guys will go ahead and find a stopping point and move back to your home groups. Allow them to take notes on it. This will be on our assessment later, so you guys need to make sure you take notes. And also give them the general background information that you found on each newborn test that you guys researched. So you have about 3 to 5 minutes. So ready, set, go.
Okay, so I had the Apgar test, which stands for appearance, pulse, grimace, activity, and respiration. And basically a test based on 0 to 2 scale, 2 being the best and 0 being the worst. And 2 pros of it, it shows if the baby needs care, and then it's a health check as soon as the baby comes out of the womb. So it's a test done immediately. The 2 cons of it, it doesn't show any long-term effects. And a baby can also get a low score, but it can still be perfectly healthy.
Within, like, that 4 minute span. But then the cons of this could be that some parents might get scared because that's the biggest problem.
And if you guys didn't get the names of the 3 tests written down, I put it back, the Do Now back up, and these are the names of the 3 tests that you guys researched. So if you guys need that for reference.
unpleasant, but that's sort of silly. I need to dig a little deeper to really find the cons. So that's what I have.
I have the triple NS. It's for at-risk and drug-exposed hepatitis. And it assesses signs of stress and their movement and their emotional behavior. Some pros. The pros are that it assesses at-risk and drug-exposed babies. And pro could be its structure because it's semi-structured. It's not too loose and not too formal. But also its structure could be a con because it doesn't elicit the baby's full behavior. And it takes time to build a relationship with the baby to understand and really assess its behavior.
Should be finishing up. And right now we're going to go back over the learning targets really quick. If we had time to, we'd be doing our problem solving activity where each home group is given a scenario in which they have to pick which test they think that the newborn needs the most at the time of birth. But we don't have time for that. So we're going to do the learning targets. So give me thumbs up, thumbs down, or kind of thumbs in the middle if you guys feel that you reached the first learning target, which is explaining the three different types of tests. Thumbs up, okay. And then I can analyze the pros and cons of each of the newborn tests, so you can have identified and analyze what the pros and cons are of each test. So thumbs up, thumbs down, thumbs in the middle. And I can identify which type of newborn test would benefit a newborn baby the most, which is what we would identify, thumbs up or thumbs down, after we did the activity. And then the homework, I'll be able to ask you guys that question tomorrow after you guys turn in your homework. Go ahead and fill out your assessment on the same sheet that your academic language handout is on. And then for your homework, you guys are being assigned to create a brochure, and you guys can pick one of the three newborn tests to do your brochure over, and you're making it to where it will be available to expectant parents.